Get ready for the dictation. Start. The world has witnessed myriad scientific and technological advancements in its journey of development. However, in this pursuit, it is often forgotten that no development is sustainable if it does not respect and honor the human rights of the people. The question is, what are human rights? To be precise, human rights are the rights which are possessed by every human being, irrespective of his or her nationality, race, religion, sex, etc., simply by virtue of being a human. They are inherent in our nature, and without them, we cannot live as human beings. Human rights and fundamental freedom allow us to fully develop and use our human qualities, our intelligence, our talents, and our conscience, and to satisfy our physical, spiritual, and other needs. By the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the nations of the world were specifically exhorted to act as the guardians of human rights. By 1966, the United Nations General Assembly adopted two important covenants which are at the same time both general and universal, one dealing with civil and political rights and the other with economic, social, and cultural rights. Both the covenants principally deal with rights which were to be enjoyed by individuals. The International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, 1966, and the Operational Protocol dealt with the rights of equality, personal liberty, freedom from arbitrary arrest and detention, freedom from rendering compulsory personal service, freedom of expression and conscience, right to participate in the administration of the country, etc. The International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, 1966, deals with the right to work, the right to fair wages, the right to collective bargaining, the right to carry on trade or profession, the right to establish institutions to conserve culture, etc. As human rights and fundamental freedoms are indivisible and interdependent, equal attention and urgent consideration should be given to the implementation, promotion and protection of all the rights. Many countries have passed legislations to bring their laws as far as possible in conformity with the spirit and letter of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and other international instruments. India is a sovereign socialist democratic republic. Long before these international covenants came into force, the Indian Constitution has guaranteed several rights of its citizens, which are known as fundamental rights, as enshrined in Part 3rd of the Constitution. Right to life, liberty, equality, dignity, freedom of speech and expression, besides religious freedom that includes right to profess, practice and propagate one's own belief, faith and worship, and right against exploitation, and rights of minorities towards culture and to establish education institutions are some of the enforceable rights which cannot be infringed upon by the state through executive action. The Constitution safeguards all citizens individually and collectively human rights by protecting basic freedoms. These are guaranteed in the Constitution in the form of six broad categories of fundamental rights which are justiciable. Article 12 to 35 contained in Part 3 of the Constitution deals with fundamental rights. Stop.